Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. My brothers and sisters, as we gather, we take a moment to recognize our need for mercy.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord God has given me a well-trained tongue, that I might know how to speak to the weary a word that will rouse them. Morning after morning he opens my ear that I may hear, and I have not rebelled, have not turned back. I gave my back to those who beat me, my cheeks to those who plucked my beard. My face I did not shield from buffets and spitting. The Lord God is my help, therefore I am not disgraced. I have set my face like flint, knowing that I shall not be put to shame. He is near who upholds my right. If anyone wishes to oppose me, let us appear together. Who disputes my right? Let him confront me. See, the Lord God is my help. Who will prove me wrong? The word of the Lord. Lord, in your great love, answer me. Lord, in your great love, answer. For your sake, I bear insult, and shame covers my face. I have become an outcast for my brothers, a stranger to my mother's sons, because zeal for your house consumes me, and the insults of those who blaspheme you fall upon me. Lord, in your great love, answer me. Insult has broken my heart, and I am weak. I looked for sympathy, but there was none. For consolers, not one could I find. Rather, they put gall in my food, and in my thirst they gave me vinegar to drink. Lord, in your great love, answer me. I will praise the name of God in song. I will glorify him with thanksgiving. See, you lowly ones, and be glad. You who seek God, may your hearts revive. For the Lord hears the poor, and his own who are in bonds he spurns not. Lord, in your great love, answer me.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. One of the 12 who was called Judas Iscariot went to the chief priests and said, "What are you willing to give me if I hand him over to you?" They paid him 30 pieces of silver, and from that time on he looked for an opportunity to hand him over. Feast of Unleavened Bread, the disciples approached Jesus and said, "Where do you want us to prepare for you to eat the Passover?" He said, "Go into the city to a certain man and tell him, 'The teacher says my appointed time draws near. In your house I shall celebrate the Passover with my disciples.'" The disciples then did as Jesus had ordered and prepared the Passover. When it was evening, he reclined at table with the 12. And while they were eating, he said, "Amen, I say to you, one of you will betray me." Deeply distressed at this, they began to say to him one after another, "Surely it is not I, Lord." He said in reply, "He who has dipped his hand into the dish with me is the one who will betray me. The Son of Humanity indeed goes as it is written, but woe to that man by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would be better for that one if they had never been born." Then Judas, his betrayer, said in reply, "Surely it is not I, Rabbi." He answered, "You have said so." The Gospel of the Lord. The prophet Isaiah was steadfast in listening to God's voice. His trust was unwavering. Put that up against the apostle Judas, who was far less steadfast or trusting. It seems many conflicting voices had filled his head, leading him to an act of betrayal.
We bring I'm borrowing a thought today from Anne Elizabeth Sweet, a Cistercian nun who wrote a reflection in Give Us This Day. We have two contrasting images of discipleship in our readings. The disciple speaking in the book of Isaiah states how he has listened to God, faithfully spoken and acted on God's word, and is willing to accept the cost of discipleship. Morning after morning, he says, God opened my ears that I may hear, and I have not rebelled. The disciple Judas, on the other hand, has been listening to other voices. Now at the Passover meal, he is confronted with the stark reality that he is the betrayer. What inner voice was he listening to that led him to be the betrayer? Doubt that Jesus was who he was? Resistance to Jesus' plan? Greed, self-interest? It raises the question, whose voice or what voices are we listening to? Are we listening daily to the words of Jesus and those who legitimately speak in his name? Do we act and speak those words regardless of what it might cost us? Or are there other voices that we listen to? It matters, for the voices we listen to influence the decisions we make. And the decisions we make can have outcomes we didn't expect.